Hello, it's me again, Irvin Ho. Welcome back to ilovelearning.asia learning portal. Thank you for staying on with me in this learning video. Last chapter, we talked about the good and the bad of slides design. Now, in this chapter 4, we would like to see how we can approach in creating more good slides with the power framework. And more importantly, the word power, P-O-W-E-R, has framed the content of the following chapters. What does this mean? Let me walk you through and give you an overview of the structure by using the word power. P, prepare for your audience. O, objectives is the key. W, weave in the stories. E, express with visuals. R, relate to best practices. This word from 5 parts in this learning video, and each part has its own chapter by itself. Let me give you a preview of what you will be learning in these 5 different chapters. P, prepare for your audience. In the business world, we always say customer is the king, but in any presentation, audience is the hero. They will make or break your presentation. Therefore, the very first part of this power framework is focuses on the audience. Majority of the presenter do not think about the audience, as the consequences they created a presentation that about themselves. They created the presentation does not meet the need of the audience. As a result, the audience does not care about what they present. Hence, this part of learning will help you to identify the hero, which is your audience, in your presentation. We will walk you through the techniques to identify and profile your audience by answering questions such as, what is the personality of your audience? Who make the decision? What is the best way to reach them? What pushback might you receive when you present to the audience? That's formed the first part of the power framework, which is the P, prepare for your audience. Let us move on to the second part, which is the O, objective is the key. In any presentation, there must be an objective. Try ask yourself these questions. Why have I been asked to speak? Whether am I speaking willingly or am I being forced to speak in the presentation? Am I trying to persuade, inform or motivate? What is the main reason for my talk or my presentation? What do I want the audience to take away from my presentation? How do I want them to be changed? And lastly, what do I want them to think, feel, or do differently after my presentation? No matter how many questions you ask, like just now, okay, the objectives of the presentation always fall into 4 categories. The first one is to inform. The second one is to teach. The third is to recommend, and the last one, the fourth, is to inspire. So, in this part of learning, we will deep dive into each category for us to design a presentation that meets the objective of our audience. Okay, the next word in the power framework is W, weaves in the stories. All presentations are stories. Storylines are our best defense against confusion. If you present something in a proper manner of a story flow, an audience can easily follow through your presentation. And a storyline is the backbone of any presentation. 90% of all presentations can be made with just 4 storylines. The first one is the reporting storyline. The second storyline is about the explanation. Third is the pitch. Fourth is the drama type of storyline. This part of learning will walk you through each storyline in detail. Okay, the next word in the power framework is E. It's about visuals. People remember information almost twice as well if an image is attached to the message. Text isn't near and effective. Make your slides simple, congruent and beautiful, and use relevant pictures and simple diagrams. Some people thought process are words oriented and others more visual oriented. We must think about communicating the concept and ideas both with words and visuals. In this chapter, we will equip you with the fundamental graphics elements in visualizing information and data that could convey your message effectively. Okay, the last word in the power framework is R, relate to best practices. Design matters, and it matters a lot in any presentation. A minimalist design approach is a strategy that allows us to focus on only what matters and avoid those distracting our audience away from our center point. This chapter will focus on design techniques and key principles that allow us to do that. You will learn about the essential components to lay out a slide with the applications of right design principles. So, in summary, this is how we power up our presentation. P, prepare for your audience. O, objectives is the key. W, weaves in the stories. E, express with visuals. R, relate to best practice. So, in the next videos, we will deep dive into the power framework one by one in every chapter. See you in the next chapters at ilovelearning.asia learning portal. Thank you. Bye.